This podcast is a member of the Place to Be Nation family. Visit us at placetobenation.com. The only place to be in your pop culture world.
Come on, come on. We call it the place to be.
Place to be, yes.
It's the place to be.
Then I shall be.
Place to Be Nation, Scott Criscola and Justin Rosero. This is the Place to Be podcast.
This is the place to be here tonight.
Time to play the game.
Oh, I'm sorry, Dennis.
I think they might hit a shock wall.
Actually, it's being John Akiyama is a better version of it.
What do you think, Woodley? You can finally tell Grant Owens you found new music.
I'll tell you what, I am impressed.
All you have to do is break out that fuck money.
Yeah, I like Big Dick myself. I'm just curious.
5 years. 5 years! We've been doing podcasts. And we have this. This is trash.
To do worse than Josh Richard.
Red am I already mad about this cause it's tis the season. The perfect gift for me would be completions and connections left from last year. Ski shop encounter, most interesting. Add his number but never the time. Most of anyone passing along those lines.
Run!
Why did I let you talk me into this nonsense?
Get some! Bring me the heads!
Yes, Herr Fuhrer!
When did these fucking Nazis get so fast? These guys would have beaten Jesse Owens!
You're bringing up Jesse Owens now? Now?
An attack on the homeland is an attack on all of us!
We gotta get back to the fucking car!
You in that fucking car!
Fucking Scott, man, that fat fuck!
You said it!
Jack those halls, trim those trees, raise up cups at Christmas cheer. I just need to catch my breath. Christmas by myself this year.
Was the night before Christmas, and all through the nation, a shitstorm was brewing right before Scott's vacation. Shocking. Scott taking another vacation at Christmas time. I thought this thing was going to be about me this year. Anyways, the weather was howling, the people inside, but our PTB co-host had something to hide.
Oh, Jesus, we go through this every time you're here.
He killed the business.
How could he kill the business? There is a business. It's not dead.
Well, if it isn't dead, he certainly fucked it into submission. He's like a walrus fucking a sad, pathetic, decrepit tiger.
What kind of metaphor is that?
God damn it, it's not a metaphor.
Fine, whatever. It's a compare-assimilation.
What the fuck is that?
Who cares what the fuck it is? Shut up. You had nothing to say when he invoked a sad tiger.
It's a good image. I thought the sad tiger made sense. Reminds me of that poster in Jim's room.
I think you can say that, you moron. All right, I got to give you...
I've got to give you props, man. It does take balls to come out publicly again and defend Triple H, man.
You know it's always a pleasure, Will.
Well, that wraps up night 8 of our Hanukkah Spectacular. We've had 8 solid nights of guests coming on and attacking Scott on every single aspect of his life. I want to thank everyone who participated, especially Dan McGinn with his thorough deconstruction of Scott's personal hygiene on night 5. From all of us here at the place...
Hold on, JR. First off, it was a great segment because he actually stayed for the whole thing. Mm. But before we sign off, I got to make a quick announcement. This is my last episode for a while.
You know, we didn't get a thank you note for him coming on the podcast. And you know, you're the one who wanted to do Assault Criscola week.
No, that's not it. That's not it. It was fun. I mean, it was mean. Always is mean because everybody's a dick. But it was good. A lot of tears. But anyway, that's not it, PIC. I'm taking a leave of absence to fight the biggest battle of my life. Biggest. Worse than defending the 2003 Royal Rumble. I have polio. And not like half polio. Full-blown polio.
Wait a minute. We still have polio?
Not we. Once again, you got glom onto my thing. Me. Yes. Polio. So I need some time to deal with the polio. I don't want to answer any more questions about it. Just let it go. That's it.
I mean, I have nothing but questions.
Well, I'm not answering them. I need my privacy on this. Gotta take care the polio.
Your privacy? You just announced it live on air that you have polio.
Yeah, and?
Yeah. You just told everyone you're dying of some weird, obsolete disease, and I can't even ask you any questions.
Correct.
Yep, all right. Exactly. Fine. Outro music, hit it. It's Walking On, Sunshine.
Play it.
All right, we're out.
So, JR, I think the song was popular in New Orleans, say, 2005?
What? Why?
Well, it's Katrina and the waves.
Are you,
waves?
Fucking kidding me? You're making Hurricane Katrina jokes right after telling me you're dying of goddamn polio.
I'm vamping. Vamping. Some people are good at it. People like Aaron George aren't. They call that a stinger.
Why didn't you just vamp your big news?
What, that I bought a Nintendo Switch?
Oh, fuck this.
All right, guys, we're out.
What the hell was that?
All right, guys, I'll talk to you soon.
Scott!
Scott?
Did he leave the call?
I think so.
Oh, he's probably getting some cookies from Greeny or something. Call him back!
Right here.
You have reached the Skippity Skype of Scott Criscolo.
He put an answering machine on Skype.
I can't take your call right now. I have a full-blown polio, and I'm going to take the next few weeks to attempt to recover through medication and leeches. Please respect my privacy. Leave your name, number, and...
He ran out of tape! He ran out of tape! He put a literal tape recorder on Skype, and he ran out.
Man, that was quite a bombshell.
No kidding! Fucking polio! I didn't even know that was still a thing!
Hey, do you think he'd shit?
You're still here, Will? No, I don't think he'd shit. Why would he even ask? Why would you even ask me that?
It says on Wikipedia that you get polio by eating shit.
Well, I mean, no one eats shit anymore. It's not eating shit. It's getting shit in your mouth by accident.
How do you get shit in your mouth by accident? I mean, you don't get shit in your mouth unless you make an obvious effort to eat the shit.
Well, I mean, I really don't think you should paint such a broad brush. I mean, you could be crafting with it, and maybe your mouth itches or something, and you just kind of ingest it by accident.
That doesn't happen. I hope we never go to, like, Germany and fucking learn about people who eat shit. That's all I know.
Well, that's how you get it.
So you're saying that Franklin Delano Roosevelt ate shit?
Well, maybe not him. Maybe for him, someone snuck in his room at night and stuffed his mouth full of shit.
Why would they do that?
Kill him with polio.
So they can just stab him or blow his brains out?
Yeah, too complicated, too messy.
Too complicated? They're already in the room.
Well, that must be what happened. He's the greatest president that ever lived.
I gotta go process this shit. Brad, can you handle the editing tonight?
Yeah, man, no problem.
All right. See you guys later.
Justin slammed down his headset and started to go, crushed that his friend had polio. Disturbed and distraught, he turned to his fella, a mentally challenged robot named Rotella.
Polio! He waits until we're on the air to tell me.
Don't be sad.
I can't help it. He's my pal, and he's dying.
I still don't comprehend your ways.
Of course you don't, Robot Rotella. I mean, I just built you out of an old refrigerator and this talking Forrest Gump doll I had laying around and the hair from my shower drain.
One day, I will understand your feelings. One day, I will shine.
God, you're beautiful. Sure.
There is no known cure for polio vaccination seen.
That can't be right.
There is only one known iron lung in the continental United States, and it is currently being used by a man named Michael V. to drown his victims in red water.
I'm not going there. I've had enough of that.
Oh, friend. Oh, creator. If only there was another way.
Who the hell's that?
She stepped through the door, and the robot's jaws dropped, with a smile on her face and her hair poorly cropped. Her chin jutted out, and she raised her right hand. Justin looked up and started to stand. With fear in his eyes, he trembled with fear. The billion-dollar princess, Stephanie McMahon, was here. I'm all grown up now,
and I listen and learn a true star. Who in the hell do you think you are?
I don't know. This is my house.
I heard a podcast where my husband, Triple H, was slandered. Do you know who you're dealing with?
What are you doing here?
To give you a piece of my mind.
Ah!
What are you going to do about it?
Quad a conundrum. If you do nothing, you are emasculated. You become the Dolph Ziggler of your household. If you hit her back, you'll be decried as a Miss, and you'll be in big trouble. I missed that game. Trouble. You get the little pieces and you go boinky, boinky, boink until they go all the way home.
What is this thing?
I built him. Scott was getting super sensitive and I just needed something to unload on, but now I'm fucking regretting every minute of it.
Who's Scott?
He's my friend. He's dying of polio.
Polio? I'd slap that polio in the face like the petulant child it is.
I don't think it works that way.
This is my ring.
Do you have a cure for polio or not?
My daddy cured my polio twice with ICOPRO.
Wait a minute. You had polio? I don't see any scars. You had polio?
Yes, sir, you cad. So I took ICOPRO nonstop for all of high school.
And it cured it. There's no side effects.
Nope. Unless you count my man voice, giant hands, and multiple genitals.
Well, I'll be honest with you. Scott could use all of those things, so how can we get our hands on some ICOPRO?
You can't, unless you have a time machine. We had to burn it after it made Gene Snitsky dead.
Well, then how the fuck can we cure Scott's polio?
Slap the taste out of his mouth.
Why are you so fucking angry?
Back me.
This is hopeless.
The walls crumbled down and the car burst through, like a coked-out Rotella escaping a zoo. The tires skidded. The horn rang with pride. But what kind of creature would emerge from inside?
Hey, what's up, whoas?
Oh, God, D'Amato, where did you get a DeLorean? Why does it have New York plates?
Hey, I got it from a boombox down at the DMV.
Jimmy? What?
Nah, I stole it from Christopher Lloyd. You know, I was frozen today.
On the set of Suburban Commando, Christopher Lloyd asked me if I wanted to see the crinkle cramp.
So listen, guys, I'm going to go back in time.
So you're telling me that this car is a functioning time machine. Rotella, go check it out.
Yes, I can feel the pure energy coursing through it. It's magical. Every pore of my being is alive, Jenny. I would like to love this car if it had it heart.
So if we go back... I gotta reprogram this thing. If we go back in time, we can get ICOPRO we need. And we can use that to cure Scott's polio. That's what you're telling me, Steph.
Oh, take me with you, Master. I would like to meet my parents.
The refrigerator? Tom Hanks? Who?
Yes.
I'm coming too.
Why?
Stephanie needs ICOPRO.
All right. Guess we're all going on a time traveling adventure.
Hop in, bitches.
Where was ICOPRO even invented?
Sensors indicate that it was created in the 1980s in the U.S.
All right. God, I can't take it anymore. God, shut up. All right, let's do this.
Soviet Union.
Oh, God, shut up.
All righty, then. I'm going to fuck my way through time.
We'll be right back. The power of reins can make you fear. Make grown men boo, make children cheer. Makes my heart twirl like hurricanes. More than erection, that's the power of reins. Makes me moist, makes me cream, cream, cream. Stronger and harder than a Stephanie dream. If he'd take me, there'd be no fight. I'm a power bottom if the feeling's right. You don't need Hunter. Don't take Shane. Don't need no condom to ride on his train. He's silky and smooth with dreamy eyes. But his hair is the true prize. That's the power of reins. That's the power of reins. You feel the power of reins.
Yeah, you feel the power of reins. That man's beautiful, beautiful. Have you seen those eyes or that hair? You know what the problem with your song was, Vince?
What's that, you pasty fuck?
It's not sensual enough. The man is a demigod. Eros reborn. Sing something that gets the juices flowing.
A demi-dog? It's a Back to the Future thing.
Back to the Future? What's that? Now screw that. Give the people what they want. Check this out. Roman Reigns. You got it, right, Vince? Come on. Roman Reigns. Kevin,
just get back to the story. Just get back to the story.
The story you took from me? Where's my story where I go on a quest to meet Roman Reigns?
No one wanted to do that. It was creepy. It was creepy.
It's beautiful. It's love. Whatever. Here's Brad walking through a dark series of corridors. I'm not rhyming anymore.
Hello? Hello?
I'm back here.
Why are you hiding in the shadows?
Look at me, Brad. Look at what they've done to me.
Ah! God, you're hideous.
Scott and Justin must pay for what they've done to us.
I mean, I'm doing okay, actually. It's been a pretty good 2017.
Look at my body! It's burned to shit!
I mean, you are actually really hard to look at. I mean, have you seen a doctor since Scott tossed you in that lava? Like, anybody?
I no longer believe in doctors.
Well, I mean, they heal bodies.
I no longer believe in bodies.
I don't know.
I no longer believe in anything. Wait, that's not true. Since the beginning of time, man has sought solace in the stars. To some, Jesus was their source of comfort. To others, Xenu, intergalactic space lord. Those deities are a source of inspiration and power, but they have turned their backs on me, especially that douchebag Xenu. No, there is only one god who gives me solace now.
Thor.
Not Thor.
The elephant with like 50 arms.
No.
Wait, was that? We can edit that. Was that insensitive?
What?
Not knowing the elephant's name. I mean, I don't think it's common knowledge that people know like what the fucking elephant's name is. But
I mean, it's ignorant, but you shouldn't be expected to know the name of every god from the Hindu pantheon.
Jeez, but then why did I bring it up at all?
I don't know. Where was I?
Huh?
You always do this. I was in the middle of a great monologue, and you had to come in with your insecurities.
You make everything about you.
I am burned to a fucking crisp, you animal.
I'm sorry about that here.
Take your hand off my motherfucking shoulder.
What's wrong?
What's wrong? I am burned. I fell in lava.
Look, we all have problems, man. I don't know if you heard this, but Carson Wentz tore his ACL. I mean, it's very sad here right now.
You seriously think that's equivalent?
Well, I mean, you know, by the transitive property, you're burned. He, you know, your knee and his knee kind of. Anyway, who's the guy that you worship now?
Revenge. I was building up to say revenge.
But how? I mean, how can we tear Scott and Justin asunder? Scott's already dying of polio, of all things.
And Justin?
I have no idea. You know, he hasn't trusted me since the weird Sesame Place after-party incident.
Well, I happen to know that Justin is going back in time to find a cure for Scott.
Who goes back in time to find a scientific cure?
I know, it doesn't make any sense. It's stupid.
So how do we get to him?
Oh, simple, naive Brad. Did you think I wouldn't have a plan? Feast your eyes on this. Get off my fucking shoulder, man!
Oh, sorry. What is that?
It's a flux communicator. Uh-huh. It lets me communicate with all my ancestors through time and space. The Morse name has been synonymous with power for eons. If they go back in time, my family will take care of Justin Rosero for us.
Hmm. And how did you get that thing?
I work for Marvel, you fucking peon.
I'm sorry.
Stop touching me, you fucking monster!
I'm sorry.
Now do something to fuck with Priscolo. He's dying anyways.
I'm sorry, sir.
I'm the fucking chosen one.
Yo, I'll tell you,
you
what I
suck.
Want.
Yo, I'll tell you what I want, what I really, really want. Roman Reigns is what I want, what I really, really want. I want a Roman Reigns, but instead you get Scott.
Gentlemen, I assume you're all wondering why I've assembled you here.
It's just me, Scott.
Well, are you a gentleman?
I am.
Touché.
So what? Why?
I called you here today to let you guys in on a little secret.
Wait, did the paperwork for your domestic partnership with Greeny go through?
Well, no! Oh, God, how many times do I have to have this conversation? I'm right here.
I'm here.
What?
Wait, are you watching Raw? I'm here. Or I'm
don't
here.
Derail. Don't derail this. You always do this. I'm here to let you in on a little secret. I don't actually have polio.
Wait, then why did you announce it on your podcast?
Why indeed, Bradford? Why indeed?
Wait, that's it? A dramatic pause? I mean, are you going to tell me?
In due time. In due time. First, let me set the stage for you.
Oh, geez, no, please do not. I do not draw this out like it's the first time the place to be covers a new building. You know, I don't need the history of every single team that's played a fucking game there. You know, it could be a chess tournament, whatever. I'm tuning in for a goddamn in your house report, and sometimes I have to sit through 15 minutes of that minor league lacrosse bullshit. I'm sorry, I got fired up there. Anyway, so it's enough. Enough. Stop, please.
All right. First off, just because we never did anything at the Palestra, stop whining. Listen, 400 and something episodes. What's the one thing everybody knows I want? To meet the game. The King of Kings, the man that runs the flamethrower. And will for decades to come. Always wanted to meet him. Feel his presence around me. But anyway, I've tried everything. I've written him. I stalked him at restaurants. Sent him DVDs. Used worn t-shirts. I've done it all. And they've all failed. But this time will be different. This time, finally, my plan is foolproof. I want to create a media storm. Around my polio.
I mean, Scott, I mean, you know, I mean, our numbers are okay, but they've kind of plateaued. Although, I mean, they're a little bit up recently, which is really nice. You know, we're trending that way. Going, with just your podcast you're talking about.
Well, starting with our continuously episodic gold standard, Bradford. See, the key is to get the attention of the Make-A-Wish Foundation. Better than John Cena. Once they hear my story about a grown man contracting a long-cured disease, decades in the making, they'll grant me any wish I choose, any at all.
And so you're choosing as a grown adult male to meet professional wrestler Triple H.
Exactly. You got it, Bradford.
Okay, so to recap, you faked having polio, a long-defunct illness, to defraud a children's charity?
Well, you don't have to be so rude about it, but yeah, pretty much.
Did somebody say defraud a charity?
Suddenly it smells like cheese in here. Virgil! How have you been here?
I heard somebody say something about free Omaha steaks. Did you say something about free steaks?
Nobody said that.
Well, shit. If somebody's talking about doing some defrauding, look no further. Then your old pal Virgil S. DiBiase, because the S stands for scamming, baby.
All right. Kind of worked last time. I guess you could tag along.
Perfect. Can I bring along the $1 million championship belt?
Yeah, sure. I don't see why not.
Cool. Then I guess my next question would be, will you buy me the $1 million championship belt?
No, absolutely not.
Well, damn. What about Olive Garden? Can we work that out? Breadsticks, meat sauce.
Ask Brad, he's got the gift cards. No, no, no.
Well, do you guys remember the time when Tito Santana and I got arrested for cockfighting?
So, all right. So the three of us will go to the head of the Make-A-Wish Foundation, make my dreams come true. But before we do, we have a rite of passage every time we bark on an adventure here during this wonderful time of the year. Bradford, you know who to bring me in. Come on, Basil.
Basil? Is that the dog that we kill every damn year? Why does that fucking witch Dr. LaRue keep bringing him back?
Oh,
ah, there you are. Yes. Bradford. Bradford, hammer, please. And wait,
knock it down. All right, pump the brakes a little bit. We kill this dog every year. I mean, look, and you could smash it with that hammer. You could stop it to death.
I could punch it in his fucking face.
You could. You could do that, Virgil. But let's face reality here. What we're doing here is, well, there's no other way to say it. Immorality of the highest order. We need all the good karma we can get. Why don't we just spare the dog?
I suppose. I mean, part of the fun's watching Dan cry. Maybe his wife will stop him from crying, but, well, he's not even here anyway.
And at worst, you know, we could eat him with some delicious Olive Garden meat sauce.
But he's your responsibility, Bradford, not mine. And don't give it to Virgil.
All right, fellas. I got a car parked out front. Are you guys ready to go?
So, listen, wait a minute. You have a car?
I mean, technically, it's a lift on layaway. Not yet.
Oh, God. All right, Virgil, let's come outside and we'll work out the details. We'll see you in a minute, Brad.
All right, come here, boy. Oh, who's a good boy? You wouldn't call me Bradford, would you, boy? Would you?
He isn't going to have sex with that dog, is he?
Now, Kevin, I wouldn't say we're that creatively bankrupt, and it certainly would never happen this early in the show. But that's a good boy, Basil. You're a good boy. You want a treat?
Yip, yip.
Well, here you go, boy. All right, now how do you feel?
Like David Justice just blasted the 600-foot homer. What do you do to me?
I guess I gave you that voice.
How?
Well, look, I mean, I know you think all we do is run a not-for-profit, barely breaking even website, but I mean, and, you know, on the back end, we do have some, it's a little magic, darky stuff.
What do you want from me?
Well, first, I want your undying loyalty.
I don't know if I can give you that.
You're a dog. That's all you are, is loyal. Now, what if I gave you some bitch to hang out with?
I appreciate that you used that word in the right context.
Oh, absolutely. I want to make it very clear to our audience out there, too. It was straight away. You know, I don't know if you've ever been to, like, a pet show or, like, a performance or anything like that where they walk the dogs around and they call them bitch like it ain't no thing. They don't even blush. So, you know, we're going to make a great team, Basil, you and me.
Woof! Yo, baby, yo, baby, yo.
Woof! What the hell was that?
I'm so sorry.
A talking dog? That'll put butts in seats. The DeLorean raced through space and time in search of a cure for Scott's fat face. With a dummy at the wheel and a hoo-ah in the back, Stephanie and company spiraled through the black. With a crack in the air to a halt they screeched. Somewhere lost in time, our heroes were beached.
When the moon hits your eye like a big pizza pie, that's amore.
Here we are, boys.
We're here.
I don't know how to work this thing. I don't even know how to work.
So we could be literally anywhere in time. We need to get to the fucking Soviet Union in the 1980s so I can do my Zoya the Destroyer impression.
Make way for the Governor Pontius Pilate!
I'm Pontius Pilate.
Excuse me, where are you guys going?
You don't talk to the Governor that way!
Now you hang on a minute, mister. Do you know who you're talking to?
Take this Gaulish woman from my sight. Now, what can I do for you fine gentlemen? You are aware that gorillas are illegal in Jerusalem?
He's not a gorilla, he's a robot I built.
Ah, roboty, I see. I'm making my way to the capital to bring justice to a criminal. Now, I do not see fault in his sayings or doings, but...
Sire, his teachings are dangerous. He would not only upset us, but also the Sadducees, if you allow him to live.
Oh, listen, I have heard your protestations. If it will make you, how you say, just shut up. Then I'll crucify this man. To the Capitol!
So you had the preacher play Pilate, you sick, twisted... Anyway, he was going to play Cain in one of my stories, one of my heroes. How's this for the plot twist? In my quest for Roman's affection, Cain was going to be a Jedi to go along with my lovable rogue.
Look, man, we got a limited time. No one wants to be part of this Star Wars Roman Reigns pornography thing you're directing here.
Hey, man, listen, I'm an artiste. So Pilate left to kill Jesus, and Justin and his gang were left with their mouths agaped and the old kibbles and bits there dangling in the wind.
Something tells me we should follow him.
You know, I've never seen a live crucifixion. I'd wager it'd be stupendous.
Oh, what's the matter, Sunshine? What's the matter?
Oh, it's the sky. Long, flowing hair, blue eyes.
Ah, so he's obviously not from here.
Oh, yes, he is. He let me wash his feet, and now they're going to kill him.
Hey, why don't you wash my... what's your name?
Mary.
Hey, Mary, Mary, quite contrary. Trim that muff, it's too damn hairy. Oh, what do you do for work, Mary?
I'm a whore.
Nice. Have you seen this car?
Is this a chariot?
It's like a chariot. And I'm like a mighty steed.
Well, I would very much like to see the inside of that car.
Yeah, I'm going to show you the inside of something, and I would very much like to pay you for that privilege.
While D'Amato went to town on the reformed madam, a trial was held for the father of Adam.
You stand accused of declaring yourself to be the son of Shawn Michaels' tag team partner, God. How do you answer?
I am who I am, my children.
You stand accused with not only the murderer Barabbas, but also Robert Douglas, who crows in the square every time there's a fight in the Colosseum, regardless of the quality. In many ways, he's much worse than either of you. We should be challenging our gladiators to do better. Why are we settling for mediocre fights with little no build-up? They've been pushing Satae of Egypt for 6 months. 6 months! And I have the right to send out the town crier to complain about him without being labeled as a hater.
I agree, Brother Pilot. It is annoying. The push feels endless.
Enough of this. Who cares about Seti of Egypt? Fuck Egypt. They think they are so great because of the pyramids and the fact that they provided every grain of food that we eat. This man came in our temple and tore shit up. Tore it up as though he was some sort of Hulk who is incredible. Kill him!
Well, he's right. You did bust up his temple. So I sentence you to...
Hold on just a minute.
Who is this beast of a female?
I'm Stephanie McMahon Helmsley. Who the hell do you think you are?
I am Father Morseberg, leader of the Pharisees.
Get out of my ring!
What is this ring you speak of?
Enough of this!
No! Enough of you.
She raised her hand and the earth stood still. Yes, she had slapped them all. But Pilot, without a care for the consequences, she not only slapped the beleaguered Roman governor, but she slapped a hole in time whose consequences would be felt for generations.
That hurt me. Hurt me on a fundamental level. I feel so emasculated. I will not kill this so-called king of the Jews because of this woman. This stone hand woman. Soldiers, let Jesus go.
Wait, what? Guys, we need to do this. I kind of have a plan, and this is a pretty big part of it. I need you to kill me.
Oh, no worries. You are absolved. Go. Find a nice girl. Settle down.
Well, if you won't kill the heretic, at least kill the outsiders.
Whoa, hold on a second. You guys mean us?
Yes, you have crossed my family for the last time.
Listen, was your last name Morseberg? Listen, Mr. Morseberg, we came here by accident, and we're just looking to get home.
Look, visitor. I promised them blood, and not the new blood. Crucify the outsiders. Start with Stonehand.
The Romans started towards them, then suddenly a ball of hair and metal stumbled from behind a salt merchant.
No, I can't let this happen. Not again. Not ever. No, you Pharisees, want some loot, but I'd not come for my friends.
You'd think there'd be many guns, but you'd be wrong. Instead of many, only one emerged. Giant penis gun. Sprung from the robot's loins, which then became six with the power, with the determination of Mormon patriarch fathering his entire city, Robot Rotella, unleashing his seed on the Romans. But on the day his seed came in from the cold street, one by one, the Romans dropped. When the smoke cleared, a shocked and disgusted Jesus stepped forward.
The Romans, you've obliterated them.
Yeah, fuck yeah, I built him a bunch of guns! Cause America, bitches!
You freed Jerusalem, you fucking morons!
Whoa there, Jesus! You're a little out of line.
I'm out of line? I had to die. I'm immortal for this. I needed to die to absolve the sins of man. Who's gonna fucking absolve the sins now?
I'll do it. I'm Stephanie McMahon.
Silence, Jezebel.
Jesus Christ, look! We didn't even mean to come here, but look what happened. We saved your life. Maybe it's a whole new start for you. Think of this grandiose opportunity you've been given. Go, grab the wanted ads, find a job, get off the couch. It's time for you to strap on your Jesus boots and get cracking on making this world a better place. Repay those debts.
Maybe you're right, my son. Maybe this is an opportunity for me to make something of this.
Why so glum, chum?
Honestly, I was really hoping this prostitute I've been hanging out with was going to come see my execution. Where the hell is she?
Thanks for the ride, John!
Anytime, sunshine. Hey, guys, I got this thing working. Hop in and I'll get us where we need to go. I figured out how to put the dates in. You just set the date and you push the button.
This guy just got laid more tonight than he has his whole life. I mean, who knew? Jesus, it's been a blast! You wouldn't happen to have a cure for polio, would you?
Polio? I'm only scheduled to unleash that one in, like, 1853. That same year, a scientist in Cheyenne named Francis Cottonwood created a vaccine.
Jesus, you have touched my soul.
You have no soul, machine. You are an abomination.
Hey, JT, what do you think of this new voice I programmed?
Get the fuck out of my sight.
See you later, Jesus.
Look, Jesus, I'm sorry I tried to have you nailed to a cross. That was a bit harsh.
The question to you is, how did you know my weakness? How did you know that iron nails are the only thing that can pierce my Jesus skin?
While Justin and company were blaspheming their way through time, Scott and his collection of merry assholes made their way to the head of the Make-A-Wish Foundation.
So let me understand what you're saying. Oh, fuck, I'm bad with names. Mr. Chris Scola?
It's Chris Scolo.
Sorry, I thought the man said Chris Scola or Crisco. I can't remember. Anyway, so let me understand. You have polio?
Yes, I have polio, yes.
And because of that, you would like to use a wish to meet Mr. Ha Ha Ha?
Fucking people. It's pronounced Triple H.
Oh, of course it is. And who is this man that's kind of leering at me from the corner? Because it's really fucking creeping me out right now.
Who are you talking about? Oh, that? Oh, that's Virgil.
Virgil... What? Does he have a last name or just Virgil?
DiBiase. Virgil DiBiase Esquire. It's a title of respect above the rank of a gentleman, but just below the rank of a knight.
Okay, so Mr. Virgil DiBiase Esquire. And what's with the talking dog? We don't really get many of those around here.
Woof, woof, woof. Well, that's a long story.
You know what? This really doesn't fucking matter. Oh, God, I hate my job. So, Mr. Crispicolo Crisco, I don't know, whatever. I think we can attempt to accommodate your request. Maybe, oh, for fuck's sake. Excuse me, sir.
Yes?
Could you please, for the love of God, stop chanting in that dog's ear? You're creeping me out.
No, that was not chanting.
Not chanting? You're speaking Latin in his ear, saying the same fucking words over and over. Make my wish happen. Make my wish happen. Yeah, you think I didn't know Latin? I know Latin.
He was telling me that the Ultimate Warrior is the greatest professional wrestler of all time. I have questionable taste like my owner, and I agree with him.
Oh, sure he was. Lie to me again, but that's okay. Now, who was the Ultimate Warrior?
Oh, you ignorant swine. How dare you besmirch the good name of Warrior? He's better than AJ Styles. Better than Whoa, Wick Flair. Better than you.
Yeah, who did you ever beat?
I really don't see how any of this is relevant.
Excuse me, Miss Marilyn. Do you know Terry?
Terry who?
Terry Bollea.
I know Terry. He's also better than Ric Flair or any other wrestler. Save the Ultimate Warrior.
Oh, God, I really hate my job. Listen, I would like to proceed with your case, Mr. Prispapola, but I can't get past these derelicts that you've brought with you here. I mean, seriously, oh, my God, I hate my job.
I can imagine you do. You've said my name 7 different times. Anyway, look, I know I run in a strange bunch here. I know that. But look, no one else will ever love these guys. I mean, look at Virgil. I mean, yeah, he looks like a broken-down piece of shit who sells pictures on the 7 train to Shea, but look at the sadness in his eyes. It's deep. Really deep. I bet if you got to know him, you'd be tripping over yourself to grant him a wish, which would be 10 bucks and some mac and cheese, but it's a wish nonetheless.
You know, I'd wish for a big old hunk of Havarti cheese, and I'd smear it all over my body, and then I'd wash it off with my tears.
You don't make this easy on anybody, do you? Anyway, look, see? And then there's Basil. Poor, poor Basil. I mean, look who owns him. And every year I want to kill this dog.
Well, oh, God, I used to love cheese. I'll never see it the same way again. Okay, wait, you kill dogs?
Well, I mean, I like dogs. It's more just to piss off the owner.
He's a living creature. Strange, talking, speaks Latin nonetheless, but he's a living creature.
After I'm done with it. I'm sorry. But see, this year I didn't kill him. And look, he learned to speak. Genius! Probably by some form of sorcery that'll bite us all in the ass later. But for now, spectacular. I wish he came in Northeastern, but you know, can't have everything.
And who's the other weird, sad guy that you've yet to mention kind of leering at me as well?
Who? Oh, Bradford?
First off, that is not my name.
Anyway, Bradford here, look, he turned my favorite person on the planet against me, who then I had to melt his face off of the lightsaber and burn him in a pile of liquid hot magma. That was your fault.
Oh, God, I really hate my job. Well, we usually reward people who have been kind to others, not those that killed dogs, so...
Look, he was an enemy. I took out an enemy of the world.
It was a whole chosen one situation. Somebody had to go.
You know, I would really like it if you never fucking spoke to me again. Just don't even remember my name, where I work. For God's sake, I'm quitting this job. Just don't, okay? Just don't.
Okay, I think I can do that.
Okay, so...
After you help me out with my query, and you know that's a big word for me, so it has to be very important. Now, I'm looking for a trademark for the phrase Ho-Ho-Hogan. It's a Christmas thing, you wouldn't understand, but... We're going to plaster this all over the country and make hundreds of dollars. Can you help me with this trademark?
Okay, first off, I understand Christmas. I love Christmas, but I'm an executive at a children's charity, and now I don't know what fucking chicks. So how exactly would you expect me to help you with your absolutely absurd, ridiculous, does not help Christmas trademark?
Well, don't worry about all that. I cleared this with Turi. So we can get this thing going, and we'll have fuck money coming out of our Santino Morellas. You want in on some of this fuck money, baby, green and black, green and black.
No, oh God, no. I do not want any fuck money. So this should have been a 2-minute conversation of me denying your application. You're an adult, more than likely faking this disease to gain access to a man who has 3 fucking H's in his name. Who needs 3 H's to create a name?
Whoa.
Okay, however, God, I need Xanax. Okay, if you promise to never, and I mean never, ever, ever bring these men around me, in my office, anywhere towards me, or that dog for that matter, I will put you on the waiting list. You'll be like 15th, but I need a hard promise to never, ever see Mr. Esquire or that talking dog ever again.
You know, hard promises are a fickle thing, like the hard breadsticks at Olive Garden, you know, they're so rustic, and the way they cook, they're hard on the outside but soft on the inside. And speaking of soft on the inside, I've had a very hard life, and I was adopted, and I have an uncle named Irwin who is very cheap, and I have a dead stepmama named Sherry, God bless her soul. One time she showed me a taint.
Oh, for fuck's sake, this is so much more information than I was prepared to put up with today. There is not enough Xanax in the world. Oh, okay, please, just please.
I mean, to be fair, though, that was during a dark period in her life when she was banging this plantation owner. You know, the plantation owner, he had a giant hog, so I guess it was cool.
Oh, just breathe, Marilyn. Ah, Mr. Criscola, do we have a deal?
Of course, yes. Of course, Jesus. Yes, we have a deal. Now, I see you have that list there. Do you mind if I take a little look at this list here? I just want to see who's ahead of me. You don't mind, right?
No, this is confidential, sir. And I mean confidential.
Oh, come on. No one. I won't say anything. Come on. Let me look. Please, let me look. Let me just get a little look.
Fucking get out!
Filled with elation and erections, our heroes sped from the room. Virgil, covered in sweat, threw his hands in the air. He waved them around as though like he just didn't care. Brad sang with delight and Basil licked himself. Scott was too proud to notice, though, as he plowed through all of his emotional problems.
Okay, guys. You got me in the fucking door. God only knows how, because you're all idiots. But I can't wait for 14 kids to die. I have to meet him now. Time is of the essence.
Essence, so that means you want me to go back in there and go to town then, right?
No, don't open the door, Virgil, ever again. No need for whatever that was.
Oh, how you's doing? Is this Northeastern for you enough, Mr. Criscolo? I was having me a piece of pots of pie and with some mulatto on it. I was sniffing around and found this magazine.
Mulatto on pizza. No wonder she lost her mind. Dog lovers. What am I supposed to do with you, stupid mutt?
Well, you know, even though I can fucking talk, I can't even see a fucking collar. And I can't tell her that her dress is written on the front of it.
Oh, my God. Good boy, Virgil. Good boy. Good boy, Basil. No, no one cares about you, Virgil. Good boy, Basil. Good boy. We can get that list.
Oh, don't you touch him. Touch me, you fucking ingrate. I'll go get the West Side Boys, and we will knock your ass out.
Hey, guys. I got a car out front, but I suggest we might have to wait for dark because that's a way better time for some B&E, if you know what I mean.
You are way too comfortable with that vernacular.
Hey, what's mine is mine, and what's yours is mine. You do know my godfather was a repo man, right? Got it standing like an outlet. Are you out, Chip? I ain't got you out yet. I'm so damn fly. I do not step.
Yeah, I pop Molly, and I pop checks. Whoa, going to Russia time, time. Whoa, going to Russia time. If you said you were a communist, then I'd say you were a Leninist. I'll knock your socks off, turned on by Nikolai Volkov. Strange things, they happen in Russia time.
Yeah, this looks right. Communist Russia. All the ICOPRO I could eat.
Wait a minute, you eat the ICOPRO?
It works best that way. That or packing it inside you.
I'm going to find that chick with a dick who banged Ivan Drago.
You understand that's a fictional character, right?
Excuse me, miss. Can you direct us to the ICOPRO warehouse?
Actually, it's the ICOPRO factory.
Oh my. Hello.
Hello.
I am Madu R. Rodella.
I'm Martha.
Did my heart loved until now forswear to beauty till this night?
I saw beauty for the first time in 1976. He worked at a dark match before the MSG house show where Bruno fought some jobber guy. I hope that match will be on a compilation in the future. That and Beauty's other dark match from the night before WrestleMania. They should put that also on tape. I'm going to send them a letter.
Hallowed be her name.
Amen.
And through her strength, we shall be saved.
Praise be to the stone hand. Let her light guide us to the heavens.
And through her grace we shall. Quiet. Someone is coming. Hey, what's going on in here? Nothing. We're just telling stories.
Yeah, we definitely weren't worshiping Lady Stonehand.
Look, I really don't give a fuck what you're doing.
Thanks, man. You know I'm here for a gig. And I know it's against the law, but it feels good to get some solid prayer time in.
And in exchange, I get to jam with the piano man himself. Wait a minute. You're Billy Joel?
Yeah, but don't tell anyone, okay? I'm trying to keep a low profile while I'm in Moscow.
Oh, good. So we're in Moscow. Great. Okay. Hey, Billy. Check this one out. Communist lady. Communist soul. On your trip to the Super Bowl. You've never seen a car in. You're looking fine. Better than our first aid at the bread line.
Yeah. I mean, it's good, but do people really want to hear songs about bread lines? Famine is kind of a downer, man.
Hey, what if I replaced bread line with gulag?
That's also depressing. People die in the gulags. Vladimir Joseph Morris is a real son of a bitch.
Listen, I just think I'm really onto something here with Communist Lady.
All right. Hey, see, check it out. Here's how I would do it. Communist girl, she's been living in her gulag world. I bet she never had a Bolshevik
or ever had a solid steel toed kick. I made it stick for that communist girl. She's been living in a breadline world. I bet she never had to eat her children or scorch the earth that her family lived on. Nazis be gone. And when she's starving, she's lurking so fine. And when she's weakened, it's easy to make her mine. You know, something like that.
That is fucking terrible. You just used all the horrible things you told me not to use. And you added a few more. Scorched earth? Are you kidding me, man? People's lives were destroyed.
Yeah, did you hear how it sounded coming out of my mouth? That's what's important. I make famine sound appealing. Sexy, baby.
It certainly got me in the mood.
I feel strange. It's like my heart is getting hard.
Come with me.
Look, I've got bigger fish to fry, but I'd really be remiss if I didn't get your autograph, Billy. For Scott, he loves you.
Oh, sure thing.
Now, wait a minute. You're some type of a singer. How would you like to sing America the Beautiful at WrestleMania?
Is that that thing you guys did last year with Mr. T?
Yes, and if you say no, I'll slap your fat face, Joel.
My lady, violence is not permitted inside the Church of Stonehand.
What the hell is the Church of Stonehand?
Nearly 2,000 years ago, the Romans were terrible oppressors. Until one woman stood up to the evil governor, Pontius Pilate. To this day, we worship her.
That was me. Father Raj, it was me all along.
No. This woman lived in the Middle East. You're some white chick with a gargantuan jaw.
You are not invited to WrestleMania.
Speaking of WrestleMania, our glorious leader is honoring Nikolai Volkov at the ICOPRO factory as we speak.
Yee! ICOPRO! We should head over there! We need that ICOPRO to cure Scott's polio!
That stuff cures polio? I thought it just killed pigs.
Just take us to the factory, asshole!
In her name, I will.
So you want to get big and you want to get slick, then you down that ICOPRO way quick. It tastes like sand, but it'll make you hoss. And if you add that size, you'll please the boss. Akeem, Yoko, and Bray Wyatt too, all have cultivated their mass on the ICOPRO diet. If buffed up men is what you want to see, follow our friends to the ICOPRO factory. Take it to the factory, boys.
And today we honor our most accomplished legitimate athlete, Nikolai Volkov. For you, I give you access to the granaries of Moscow whenever you need to feed. Get bigger, Nikolai. Get stronger and destroy that American scum Hulk Hogan and bring glory and honor to Mother Russia.
Thank you, Vladimir Joseph Morse. You are, as always, the greatest leader we've ever had. Now please, join me in singing our national anthem.
This is where Duggan usually comes out. I don't know.
This is how you sing the Russian anthem, just like Nikolai Volkov would do.
Did you sing the anthem?
It's Volkov. How am I not going to sing the anthem?
Oh, great. You here to ruin a perfectly good Russia as well?
Oh, Jesus Christ. What are you doing here?
What do you mean, what am I doing here?
You were supposed to die 2,000 years ago, remember? For our sins?
Yeah, I was supposed to die. You got that part right. So you guys came and fucked it all up. You and fucking Stonehands over here.
I knew it. I knew I was Stonehand.
Where's D'Amato, by the way?
Hey, I'm right here, Jeeves.
Listen, you son of a bitch. I had to raise your son.
What?
You impregnated my wife Mary before you left. She told me it was mine. We don't have DNA tests back then or anything, but I fucking knew.
How'd you find out?
One, I'm Jesus. Two, his first word was whore. What kind of a child's first word is that?
Hua, hua. I have a son. Guys, I'm a father. Can I meet my boy?
Yeah, sure. He's buried by a tree in southern France.
Buried? What do you mean? He's dead?
Yeah, it's been 2,000 years, you moron. Of course he died.
Aw, man. I'm not prepared for any of this.
You think I was prepared to raise some fucking Guido kid? Now I gotta live with this murder for all of eternity.
What'd you expect with this whore of a mother?
My dead wife, you son of a bitch!
Guys, quiet! Listen, we gotta get the stash of ICOPRO. Stephanie, you come with me.
What do I do?
You just stay here and stop singing. Shut the fuck up.
But I've gotta convince Billy that I can go.
Where the fuck is Rotella?
I have never felt this way before.
He said with the soul of a greased-up viscera.
Neither have I. You are intoxicating.
She said like the know-it-all asshole that she was.
I wish I could stay with you forever.
Said the machine in a Linda McMahon-esque fashion.
Actually, that's impossible.
She sternly said with all the love she could possibly muster.
Oh. Oh, Jenny, how I wish you were from my timeline.
Don't change the fucking timeline.
What are you doing here, American scum?
I'm sorry, comrade. We were just passing through.
Shut up. That's not true. We're proud Americans, and we're not going to let you push us around. Just like when my daddy, Vince McMahon, didn't let the gays push him around with their gravy bowl.
Wait, you know Vince McMahon? How do I get the pushkey?
You show us where the ICOPRO is, and I'll tell you.
Here's 10 pounds of it. I carry it with me at all times.
Take that ICOPRO, and you shove it so far up your ass you can taste it.
You do not know biology.
Trust me, it works. Look at my teeth.
Good Lord. Okay, thank you.
They thought they were safe, but suddenly Vladimir Joseph Morse appeared.
Well, 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 if it isn't our heroes, Justin Rosero and Stephanie McMahon. Where is your friend, J. Arsenio D'Amato, getting Russian hepatitis from, how you say, Hortons?
I'm Zoya the Destroyer. Listen to me, Morse. All you need is a Psycho Pro. We'll be on our way, okay?
What, so you can save your friend Scott from the polio? You expect me to help you?
How do you know about Scott?
I know many things. I have friends in marvelous places.
Fucking Ben! Is he back from the dead, that fucking freak?
No. Look, whether he is dead or not is inconsequential. What is consequential, or rather what isn't inconsequential, is the fact that you are now my prisoners. Comrades, take them to the gulag. Oh, and by the way, ICOPRO does not cure the polio. We used it to fertilize land after scorched earth.
Yeah, I just wanted to eat it. I just wanted to eat more ICOPRO.
They needed a miracle. Stephanie had stuffed her face so full of ICOPRO that the prospect of running was as plausible as Triple H showing vulnerability. Morse brought his hand down to signal their execution when suddenly an angel appeared.
He's got a way about him. Don't know what it is, but I know that he's mighty stalling. He's got a way about him. Don't know what it is, but I know that he's as strong as lightning.
Amazing. Praise be unto her, Lady Stonehand.
Are they practicing religion?
Yep.
You may be right. I may be Stalin. Oh, but it just may be a KGB you're looking for.
Is that American singer Billy Joel?
Shit.
Seize him.
No, please. I'll do anything.
My grandson's vendetta will have to wait. You think you are so special with your low-key songs about New York City and dreaming in rivers. And now look at you. My Nikolai is much better singer. Have you heard his Cara Mia?
I just came here to, you
be
know.
Be silent or be silent.
Oh, please, sir.
Nikolai.
No!
Now's our chance!
Should I slap?
No, just run, you jacked up fucking bitch!
Justin quickly smashed Stephanie till she rolled on her side. He proceeded to roll her through the halls of the ICOPRO factory, through the screams of petulant child and do you know who I am? Justin smiled as his dream of rolling an ICOPRO'd out woman down the corridors was finally coming true. Stephanie slammed into the DeLorean with a mighty fuck the tomorrow. D'Amato was there and they were getting out of here.
Everyone, just get in the car!
Hi, guys.
Damn it, Rotella! Get in the fucking DeLorean!
Guys, this is Marta Schmock. I love her. I'm staying here.
Fine, fine, fine!
Don't try and talk me out of it, Jenna.
I'm not.
Where are we going?
There's a guy in the Wild West with the vaccine.
Alright, punch it, bitch!
Wait, take me! They're going to make me Nikolai Volkov's singing coach.
There you are, music man. Come with me. We have much work to do.
Marta Schmock, will you marry me?
You're supposed to be on one knee. Unacceptable.
I love you. I la 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 the thing you make my hair stand, you make my circuits sweat, I am sweat, I am sweat. There was a time when I thought I'd be alone, I thought that no one would love my robot haired. Then you walked with your precision and your stats and your furious attention to detail. I love you. And now Rodella rest. And now we blast off, Jenny.
Nine months later, Robot Rotella and Martha Schmuck welcomed a son into the world. We all know how that turned out. Hey, how about you picture this instead? The inside of a ship. I'm flying. Kane by my side. Suddenly the Empire blows up, but this time it's run entirely by women. Now I have a power where I can see right through their clothes.
Whoa, where is this going?
So they've been through a lot with the Death Star and all. So their clothes, they start to like rot.
Will
off.
You stop?
Now, listen, I'm in a committed relationship, so I concentrate on flying the ship. So Kane goes back there, lightsaber in hand.
I'll have you take it out of here in a minute.
Remember when I sang the Seamus song?
Yeah.
That really made Seamus.
Well, I mean, I guess. I guess.
Fella! Scott and his gang show up at the Make-A-Wish Foundation workers' home.
This is a nice house. So exactly how do we plan on getting in this house?
I'll run around and see if there's a back door.
Oh, good job, Basil. Good job. Glad I didn't stomp that fucker to death.
Me too, for it will seal your doom.
It? Huh? What'd you say?
Nothing. I wasn't. Not me.
Hey, guys. I got an idea. It's crazy enough to work. Why don't we take this Colt 45 bottle and turn it into a Molotov cocktail, and we can throw it through the window.
Whoa, Virgil, no!
But it was too late. Virgil wound up and, with an arm full of sadness, tossed the Molotov cocktail through the window. The living room went up as quickly as Jim Ross on the floor of an interview room during an attack by Kane.
What the hell is going on out there?
Yes, someone better have a Dan McGinn good explanation for blowing up our living room.
Shit, she can't see me. Take me, she took me right off the list. Virgil, go say something. Cover for me.
My chaise lounge is on fire. Why? My precious chaise lounge is on fire.
Hey, I know Chaise Lounge. I used to wrestle him back in the day. But, you know, I know this looks bad.
Oh, fuck no, not you.
Hey, Miss Marilyn, nice to see you again.
You people need to leave, right?
You people? What do you mean, you people?
What?
See, I see the issues here. I'm woke. I think it's plainly obvious. You don't want me here because I'm...
Don't even say because you're black. It has nothing to do with your fucking color.
Good, because I'm not black. I'm OJ.
You're not black? Your skin is black?
Yes, but my soul is white. I'm transracial. I identify as white.
White. Your soul is white. Okay.
Now, Marilyn, we better hear him out.
Hear him out? He threw a fucking bomb through our window and burnt my chaise lounge, my precious chaise lounge! And you want me to hear him out?
I know this seems crazy, Marilyn, but look at this man. Look into his eyes. Do you see what I see? Do you see a sad news whose profundity may be bottomless?
Who you calling a profundity?
It's okay, Virgil. I have no idea why I know your name, but I'm here. I'm here for you. You can talk to me. I won't judge you. I won't hold your feelings hostage. I'm here to help. Is there anything that you'd like to talk about? Your pain, maybe? Where does it come from?
Well, I guess my pain sort of started when they named me after a 300-pound white man with a liver spot.
And why did they do that?
I don't know, just being petty, I guess.
You know you're not a 300-pound white man, right?
Don't be stupid, man. Of course not. I'm a striking 250-pound white man. I'm the other Hemsworth brother.
Well, sure, you are striking, but, you know, whatever you want to be, Virgil.
You know, my daddy would disagree with you, though.
Tell me more about that.
He was just so demanding. I mean, he'd be all like, shine my shoes, Virgil. Drive my car, Virgil. Get suplexed on the stairs by Turi at WrestleMania No. 4, Virgil.
Are you under the impression that the million-dollar man Ted DiBiase is your father?
He was my father, was, until little Teddy came along and he took my place on the teat. I wanted to suckle on that sweet, sweet DiBiase teat.
I know this is breaking HIPAA, but Parv was in the hair before, and, well, we've all thought that at some point.
You know, there was just always someone else he wanted more than me. First Andre, then Sherry, Uncle Irwin was next. And finally, little Teddy. At least he let me plow Sapphire, but, you know, that was like screwing a starfish, you know? So no matter what I would do, it was just a lot of jiggling and flopping, and I'm just sitting there like, what more do you want from me?
So you realize none of this was your fault, Virgil? Ted DiBiase, while not your father, was also a terrible, terrible man who let you plow Sapphire. Do you know that?
Now that you put it like that, I do see it like that.
And when you won that million-dollar belt from him, how did it feel?
Oh, man, it felt good. It felt like I was worth something, like I was at the OG and it was unlimited soups and salads day.
Oh, wow. Did you get breadsticks, too?
With meat sauce.
Oh, yeah. You are worth something, Virgil. At least $29.95 for an 8x10.
You're damn right, Doc.
Oh, I'm no doctor. I'm just scamming this Marilyn here for that sweet, sweet charity money.
Oh, nothing wrong with defrauding, brother. Bring it in.
While Virgil worked through his deep-seated issues, I decided this would be the best time to break out my Ted DiBiase impression. You know how everybody's got a price for the million-dollar man. And I don't care if you're Virgil, Nikolai Volkoff with a penny sign on his tights, or that bum Sapphire, you will be bought. Also, Scott snuck back in the house and stole the Make-A-Wish waiting list. He was climbing out the back door, oblivious to the reality that he was being watched.
I've got it! I've got the list.
Wait just a cozy can of Moto Minute, though.
I got the list. Wait a minute, another fucking talking dog? Do we have a budget for this?
I'm afraid I can't let you leave here with that.
I want you to know something, you fucking mutt. I have stomped many a dog to death in my day.
You don't scare me. Sure, my owner's that pansy over there making nice with your African-American friend on the front lawn. But his wife, Marilyn, is a terror most have never seen. I will chew through your face until it looks worse than a cane match.
That would mean I have no face left, but I need that list!
I'm sorry. I will give you until the count of the average Yoshihashi star rating, which is 3. 1, 2...
Stop it! Stop it! Will you get away from my friend?
Oh, you don't want to play this game, chum.
This is no game!
Oh, that's where you're wrong, Chief. It's all about the game and how you play it.
It's all about control!
And how you can take it!
Triple H, you know of him?
He's my favorite guy, Jim.
Me too! We should be fighting! We should be watching Triple H matches together!
Yeah, like when he squashed that no good criminal Booker T at WrestleMania. That was great.
Yeah, or when he beat that piece of shit Ric Flair at Survivor Series.
Yeah. Oh, I never expected to find someone so on the same wavelength as me in the middle of a break in an entry.
Me neither.
I tell you, I don't want to wait anymore.
Me neither.
Let's do it.
I can't fight this feeling any longer.
And yet I'm still afraid to let it flow.
What started out as friendship has grown stronger. I only wish I had the strength to let it show.
I'll never peg you as a bass singer. I tell myself that I can't hold out forever. I said there is no reason for my fear. Cause I feel so secure when we're together. You give my life direction. You make everything so clear.
And even as I wander, I'm keeping you inside.
You're a candle in the window on a cold, dark winter's night. And I'm getting closer than I ever thought I'd find. Sing it with my dog. I can't fight this feeling anymore. I've forgotten what I started fighting for. It's time to bring this ship into the shore and throw away your forever. Cause I can't fight this feeling anymore. I've forgotten what I started fighting for. And if I have to crawl on the floor, come crashing through your door. Baby, I can't fight this feeling anymore. I love you.
The two dogs embraced. Basil came down on Rex with the force of 1,000 violins. And you guys scoffed at my cane space erotica. The time machine then found itself barreling through the desert.
You guys have got to help me.
We got to help you?
Well, Big Millie Billy Morse's gang is at it again. They're down at the saloon making it Francis Cottonwood dance with the guns.
Who the fuck is Francis Cottonwood? Where have I heard that name before?
That's the name of the guy who invented the polio vaccine, you fucking dunce.
Well, he is something of a scientific.
Hey, my dudes, you got any hoo-ha houses around here?
Well, you could hit up the Studded Stallion down past the bank.
Studded Stallion? How much do you think that 35 U.S. dollars will get me? How much snatch will that get me?
Well, I reckon all of them. You could probably buy all of them.
All right, you're going to take us to the saloon, Sheriff.
Now, this Billy Morse's gang has been trouble from day one. They rode into town arguing about some sort human panther hybrid, and well, they haven't stopped arguing since.
What's this about Billy Morse himself? Is he as much of a douchebag as I imagine him to be?
Ha ha ha! That's funny. Women use douchebags to clean their clamshells, and you're calling him ha ha the bag. Well, big bad Billy Morse is trouble and a half. Likes women, kills men, and sucks a mean horseshoe.
You bring him to me, he'll cower from my steely gaze and razor-sharp cheekbones.
I reckon he'd be more likely to be frightened by your horrible hair and your strange high bones.
Yeehaw! Make him dance, boys.
Here he is, boys. Lay low. We'll need to sneak up on him.
Make me laugh, Francis. Make me laugh like the guys in the funny pages.
Oh, now, Greg, you know I can't do that.
Then dance, you varmint. Dance like your legs are on fire, like you're some sort of human torch.
Now, that's a stupid idea. A human torch?
Hey, fuck you, buddy. I bet it's such a great idea you could have two of them, and people wouldn't even blink an eye.
Well, how'd that shit even work? Like, would the guy be holding some kind of a torch of some kind?
No, he'd just be on fire.
A man on fire? That's fucking bullshit. He'd need to be some kind of a metal man of some kind.
What do you think, Stan Lee?
Oh, I don't know. I'm only 15. I don't know too much about anything to do with metal men. Nuff said.
Muff said? Muff said what?
What in the name of Stonehand are you doing, you pig?
You know, fellas who wishes they were a metal man right now? Francis. Now, Francis, you think you're so much smarter than anyone else with your numbers and your book reading. You don't look so smart now dancing in the street.
Guys, please, I don't know what you want from me. I'm just a simple scientist.
There's that word again. Science something. People don't like science. Right, Stan Lee?
I like science!
Oh, yeah? You think you're smarter than me?
I didn't say that!
No, come on, smartass. Tell us how stupid we are. Give us one idea that's better than old Tim's green light bulb character.
Oh, light bulbs are tacky. You want some kind of green...
You can't even come up with a noun, you 15-year-old punk.
A lantern. A green lantern.
What'd you call me?
Oh, leave little Stanley alone. Back on, Francis. You know, Francis, I can imagine you and your little family getting all science stuff and blasting yourselves when you're invulnerable into the sky. Y'all come back with some freaky powers.
Now that's a great idea, true believer.
Ha! Okay, Stanley, next you're going to tell me that with all that science, he'll maybe turn himself into some sort of spider person.
Next you're going to tell me about some sort of scientific doohickey that can prove this here Earth is flat.
Yeah, good one, Tim. Make him dance again.
This is horrible. Why aren't you stopping this, Sheriff Pete?
Well, Billy Morse is a son of a bitch. He busted my nose pretty badly last month and made me eat a pine cone. I don't want to cross him again.
You're a fucking pussy, Sheriff Pete, you Winnie the Pooh-looking motherfucker. You make me sick!
I wouldn't even slap you.
We'll handle this, Steph.
Stanley, you better shut your mouth or I might just pop claws out of my fist and slash your face.
Oh, you're such a kidder, Timothy! Excelsior!
Hey! Which one of you is Big Bad Billy Morse?
Who wants to know?
I do.
Well, looky what we got over here. A regular Captain America.
Yeah, drape the red, white, and blue around him. You could call him some kind of hero.
I fucking love heroes.
Don't mind him. It's past 2 o'clock in the morning, so he's drunk.
Oh, I'm not drunk, you son of a whore.
Sit down, Nick. God damn it, you always do this.
Nobody around here tells me how or to drink or when to drink. You guys are assholes. Tried my best. Tried my best.
Don't mind my boys. They get a little wound up when they get in the flow. But just so you know, you ain't leaving this town alive.
Don't you threaten us. I'll slap.
You take one more step towards me and I'll drop you like a bag of hammers.
Yeah, we don't live in some pansy-ass world where you don't get your comeuppance.
You ain't burying any of us, you fucking maypole.
Yeah, which I will smash your face if you just take one step forward, my friends.
Stan Lee. Woo-wee! Who knew you had it in you?
Oh, I tried my best.
Damn it, Nick, you friggin' fucking lush. What's it gonna be, Rosero? Die now or die painfully now?
Hi, Stanley Lee. If you ever come across a lad by the name of Ben fucking Morse, don't hire him. He is the goddamn Antichrist.
Don't you listen to him, Stan.
What's a Christ?
So how's this for far-fetched? Justin Rosero ran so fast that he was able to free Francis Cottonwood from the outlaws before they even knew what happened.
That's not what it says.
You think I'm reading Justin move with the grace of a gazelle? No way! Not unless there's a Dell's lemonade stand nearby.
You're a giant pasty dick.
That line wasn't there.
What the hell just happened?
He moved so fast, we could barely see him.
He was like a fucking Flash.
That's a stupid name. Flash.
Search the town. Don't let him get away.
JT pulled the scientist aside, desperate to find the cure for polio.
I can't thank you enough for saving me. Those Morse boys really get off on making me piss my pants.
Did you piss your pants?
Yes. But luckily I invented a latex lining that reroutes the urine to my shoe.
So your shoe is full of piss?
No. I invented a latex tube that routes the urine to my left shoulder.
All right, dude, I've had enough.
It's really an elaborate system.
Look, I just don't want to hear about your urine tracking system.
Look at this. This is a corkscrew for your penis.
Unless I was sitting in an arena watching Stampede Wrestling, I don't know why I would need a corkscrew for my fucking penis.
Just think about it.
Look, Francis, do you have the cure for polio?
Why, yes, it's right here. But it's not complete. It's missing something. I don't know what. Maybe some urine?
It's not going to work?
No, my tubes work.
Not your tubes. This polio vaccine. It's too new. Doesn't work.
Well, why don't you help us fix it?
You know this guy?
Yeah, he's the immortal messiah 2,000 years ago.
Why is he only wearing a robe?
Yeah, fuck Jesus. Just cover up, for Christ's sake. You're hanging out all over the place.
What's the point? What's going to happen to me?
Well, first of all, you'll be arrested.
Have some fish.
Well, it's good to see you still have your Jesus powers, anyway.
You fucked me, you know that? I needed to die on that cross. You sentenced me to an eternity on this shithole.
You made this place.
No, that was my dad.
Aren't you your dad?
Yeah, it's super confusing. You want to eat my body.
Jesus, no. No, I don't want to eat your body. Did you ever give me those speed powers before? Is that what happened?
No, Justin. Inside each of us is a dormant seed that, when unlocked, gives us limitless powers. Some of us gain speed. Others gain invulnerability. And some can spew fish from their hands.
What are you saying, Stanley?
That you're immune, Jesus! Come with me and I'll explain everything.
Stan Lee then soft-shoot his way up the stairs, surprisingly limber for a man of his age. What's that? He's 15 in this one? Yeesh. Scraping the bottom of the barrel for ideas, aren't we?
So, where are we going to get that completed polio vaccine?
You know who was on the vanguard of medical breakthroughs? The Nazis.
I suppose that's not the worst idea I've ever heard.
Yeah!
Oh, yeah!
D'Amato, you're right. You're not walking well.
Ah, the studded stallion was not what I thought it was.
Did you at least get your 35 bucks worth?
Ah, of course. They got a rusty trombone special every Thursday. You drive, I need to lie down in the trunk.
Yeah!
35 bucks, that's like a drink at a cocktail hour.
They got in the car and left. Is this thing almost over? With list in hand, Scott began killing his way through the Make-A-Wish Foundation waiting list. First was a longtime smoker hoping to meet Oprah Winfrey.
Please don't hurt me. Smoking has already ruined my life.
Oh, Jesus, shut the fuck up. Come here, you stinky shit. Next to the gardens of Argentina in search of a veritable legend.
What are you doing here, Mr. Joe Piscopo?
Oh, I've wanted to do this my whole fucking life. For years, people have mispronounced my fucking name because of you, you moron.
Don't blame the mighty El Gigante.
You know what? Ludwig Borga sends his fucking regards.
Very nice, I finished for you. My queen size bed. Bury me in my queen size bed. It's my most prized possessions.
You're burying your queen size bed.
My leggings.
But Ludwig Borga would never get that message. Instead, El Gigante got a screwdriver through the scalp. He then made his way to Jay Hinchy's house.
So, Jay, what do you think about this baseball bat?
Oh, it's not that bad.
Ow! Oh!
Yeah, it's fucking great now. Scott bludgeoned him until his living room ran Atlanta Braves red with blood. Take that, Jay. You don't have to post spoilers immediately after every show. You know where that lands you? In the morgue. He followed up by stopping by a certain Dan McGinn's house.
Did you steal my dog, you son of a bitch?
That was the easy part. This is the fun part, because now your life's gonna be stolen!
Where's Basil?
I hate you, Dan!
Scott tightened the rope around his neck as he watched the life leave Dan's body. Scott had never been happier or more aroused. He then went to a child's home who had the flesh-eating disease. You know what? This is getting really dark. Let's just say numbers 11 to 3, Scott killed a lot of kids. He continued his disgusting trek up the Make-A-Wish waiting list until he stumbled into number 2. Wait a minute. Virgil. Virgil, you're on the list. Are you dying?
Shit, I've been dying for years, man. Just sitting alone at photo booths and Olive Gardens trying to get Terry or Dad on the phone.
Well, I knew your career was dying. I'm going to get a Make-A-Wish for that, but... Wait, do you have an actual disease?
I believe it's called avarice. I need to get my old lifestyle back, baby.
I know a place you can get that great life back. Heaven!
Stonehenge!
Yes.
With Stonehand. Think of all the friends you'll see there. Andre, Rick, Randy.
No. I always hated Randy. I preferred Lanny because, you know, Randy, he fat-shamed me one time at a buffet.
Well, could tell him what you think about him when you see him in Stone Heaven.
I reckon.
Do it, Virgil. You'll be able to make peace with Dusty Rhodes for stealing his name.
That is true.
Virgil, besides being more hung than me and knowing how to spell your name, your life is the saddest human experience I've ever witnessed.
Come here, Virgil. I can make this easy for you. Here, take this plastic bag from Zaxby's. Put it on your head. And just let me take care of you. Just make it easy.
It smells so indescribably good. Would you please think about it, Dad, for me?
Sure we will, Virgil. Sure we will.
And also, can you thank the dude whose house I threw that Molotov cocktail into?
Yeah, I guess we could do that, sure.
This is really fucking dark, but, you know, they're going to be happy that you're dead.
You know, wrestling superstars never die, but even when we do, you know, they won't be alone either, you know. So, I guess this is goodbye, guys, and thank you. Thank you for making the last few weeks of my life most meaningful they've been since I warned everybody that Yokozuma was coming.
Yokozuma. Goodbye, Virgil.
Now I know why you cry.
All right. So who's number one?
You know, it's blacked out on the list. Like, they don't want someone to hunt down and kill this person.
I could sniff it.
Yeah, go ahead and sniff it.
I think I got it.
All right, let's hunt down this last sick fucking kid and get me in the room with the game, baby.
Hey, you remember the plan, Basil?
Yeah, yes I do, but...
But what?
I've just never eaten anything like that before.
Look, trust me, it's just like anything else. You just chew it down, take your time, and swallow it.
I guess, but I may need some Zach sauce. What does it taste like?
Grapes. And chocolate. But don't worry about the chocolate thing. I mean, that'd be a lot of chocolate. It's probably very, very tiny. So you wouldn't be dying or anything.
Well, I like grapes, and I'm not dying.
All right, put her there, partner. No, raise your paw. No, raise one paw or forget it. Just let's get on the leash.
Woo! Oh, man!
I feel the love on sunshine. Oh, walking on sunshine.
We're now going to Nazi Germany. When does this become a Christmas play?
All right, this looks right. Smells like Nazi Germany to me.
You can smell a country.
You can't?
No, of course I can. I'm Stephanie McMahon Helmsley.
All right, we just got to figure out where we are and how far we are from Hitler's camp.
Hello?
Jesus Christ, where did you come from?
Jesus who? What a strange expression. My name is Stuart Hart. I'm training the British soldiers in hand-to-hand combat.
All right, great. Where's the U.S. camp?
The United States. They're not in the war. Damn coward Yankees refusing to fight.
What? Why? Aren't there other armies here, too?
No. Just us left, I'm afraid. The Kaisers have run roughshod over all of Europe.
The world isn't outraged about all those concentration camps?
The what?
The extermination of the Jews?
Why would anyone be upset about that?
Are you kidding me? What the fuck universe is this?
Why would anyone be upset about a little tribe that the Romans destroyed 2,000 years ago?
So there's no Jews?
Of course not.
Is there brisket?
What is brisket? Oh, by the way, this is my wife, Helen.
Hello, darlings.
Oh, nice to meet you. Any chance you can point us in the direction of Adolf Hitler's camp?
Sure. But are you sure you gents are ready to take on the might of the Third Reich?
Why wouldn't we be ready?
I'm ready for anything, if you know what I mean.
No, I don't. What do you mean?
Woohoo, I know what he means, darling.
Oh! Oh, do you hope to make a cuckold of me? You wish to place the horns upon my head?
Cockerties. No, Stu, I wasn't doing anything.
Seriously, Stu, he's just a New York pussy. He's an idiot. He doesn't know what's going on. We're just using him for his DeLorean.
I'll have you know my wife has a New York pussy, right? I don't know anything about DeLoreans or perverse sexual pussy predators. But I know an insult when I see one. You need to get stretched.
No, Stu, come on. I didn't even make the comment.
If you wanted to try me, all you had to do was try
me. Ah! Fuck! Oh, God, that hurts!
Stuart Hart was stretching the shit out of Justin when Stephanie raised her mighty arms in the air. With Dino Bravo-like strength, she brought down the shovel upon Stuart's head. The light vanished from his eyes. Something changed in Stuart, and this once articulate man was starting on a path from which few return.
Take that, you fucking red coat!
Red coat, if you wanted to try me, Reg, all you had to do was try me.
Oh no! What have you done to my Stuart?
I put his brain in abeyance.
Hey, and the other day I met a Chinaman and he was selling me on the treadmill and he offered me some chopsticks and I said, "The chopsticks, my son's
oh, not like the Stuart.
Chopsticks. People like the chopsticks. And Reg, if you wanted to try me, Reg, all you had to do was try me."
Oh, Stuart. Oh, Stuart.
Hey, come here, baby. I'll give you a nice Canadian bow tie.
D'Amato comforted Helen Hart the way he comforts himself late on a Wednesday evening. Let's move on from that reality to a more pleasant thought. Off in the distance, they heard Hitler.
And finally, we will crush the British and be the greatest power in all of Europe. Then we will break America. The president is nothing but an invalid, too weak to even get out of his chair. A weak man for a weak nation. And with my right-hand man, Herr Mossenstein, we will finally deliver the final victory we have all been waiting for. Herr Mossenstein.
And also be on the lookout for these men. If you see them proceed with extreme caution, one of them is a sarcastic man, possibly wearing a veil and oat shirt. He is accompanied by an Amazon, one of our allies from the South, and possibly a very hairy robot. A huge reward to whoever brings me their heads.
Shit, they're onto us. I didn't know about my shirts. You think Stu Hart turned us in?
Stu screwed Stu.
All right.
Thank you, Mossenstein. And now a word from our Chancellor.
All right! Some fucking Germans in this piece! Hey, everybody! Throw your hands in the air while I butcher your national anthem! Deutschland! Uber Alles in der Welt! Wenn es Staats zu Schutz und Truth! Brüderlich Zusammenhalt! Wandermas, Wander Echt, Duschfrauen, Duschwein, Salin in des Wort beheten, Duschfrauen, Duschwein, and Duscher sang. Jesus, Stonehands, that wasn't hard. Hard on the voice. You guys are doing a bunch of Sig Heiling. How about we start some Sig Vincing? Sig Vince, sing Hulk Hogan, sing the Warlord, or better yet, sing Haku.
Now that's a man. You see his back? He's flexing his fucking back.
Look at that back, assholes! All I care about are my lats and my cats!
Please, Herr Vince, we spoke about the cats.
You got a problem with pussies, you mustachioed freak? What are you, like 5'5"? You think you'd be able to give such a great speech with Big Show's cock in your mouth?
What is this Big Show cock you speak of?
You haven't heard of the Big Show? What about Roman Reigns?
I have not heard of him.
Of who? Pronouns, pal! Get it right!
I have been trying with the pronouns. That is difficult.
Wait until you see Roman Reigns. You're going to come so hard. Those long-ass socks you wear tucked in your pants will be filled to the brim. Just thinking about it makes my pussy wet.
Du hast una pussy?
Yeah, it's right in the center of my chest. secreting through my goddamn shirt! I'm gonna take my pussy, this pitcher of Armento, and this cure for polio, and head to my private tent for some rape and relaxation! Yo, that's it, he's got the cure for polio!
I'll get it from him.
Stephanie sidled into the tent with a devilish look in her eyes. Whose dream was she about to make come true? You know what's crazy? I'm not even fazed by this nonsense anymore. After years of cutting Ultimate Warrior promos and tiny parves, this almost feels normal.
You know what I hate about that Hitler besides the genocide? He's a fucking sneezer!
Hello.
Oh, Jesus H. Stonehands, who are you?
I'm Stephanie McMahon Helmsley, damn it.
Well, I'm Vincent Kennedy McMahon, damn it! And you're the sexiest piece of meat I've ever seen in my life! And I got the magic stick! If I know I can hit once, I can hit twice! I hit the baddest chicks! Shorty, don't believe me! And I'll come with me tonight, I'll show you magic! What? What? Magic! Uh-huh! I got the magic stick! Leak of the core, get a dose once, you're gonna want some more! My tongue touch your gal, your toes bound to curl! Wow, this shit I don't share with the world! Have you up early in the morning, moaning! Back shot, proper or low, can't stop us! Been a fiend, 4 cents, rock him, made hits! Get in position, down pat, then it's time to switch! I'll rock the boat, I'll work the middle, I'll skeet it up, straight beat it up! I ain't in the hood with my toast out looking. I'm in the telly working up a street stroking. Tonight's the night you can fall in love. You can call your mama right now. Tell her you met a thug. I pop a lot of shit because I can back it up. My left stroke's the death stroke.
I got the magic clip. I'm on fire lick once. I get licked twice. I am the baddest chick. Shorty, you don't believe me? Then come with me tonight and I'll show you magic. Magic, I got the magic clip. Little Kim, not a whore, but I sex a daddy so good. He gotta tell his boys when it come to sex, don't test my skills. Cause my head game, have you head over heels. Give a daddy the chills, have him pay my bills. Buy matching Lambos with the same color wheels. And I ain't out shopping, spending dude seed notes. I'm in the crib, giving daddy's deep throat. Tonight, little Kim, have you in the zone? Girls call you crib, I'm answering the phone. Guys wanna wife me and give me the ring. I'll do it anywhere, anyhow, I'm down for anything. Couple of humps, give a daddy goosebumps. This junk in my trunk ain't made for chumps. When little Kim's around, you don't need to lie. It's the drugs, baby, I'm making you high. And I'm your daughter.
Are you serious? When you came in here, I wanted to induct you into the pussy posse. And by that, I mean people that play with my chest pussy. But then you hit me with the fact that you're my daughter? The fruit of my loins? Look at my chest. It's wet as October. Dive in there.
Gonna take a little time to think things over.
Open it up, baby. Open it up.
I better read between the lines in case I need it when I'm older.
It's glistening! Oh!
Now this mountain I must climb feels like a world upon my shoulders.
Look at these mountainous lats!
Through the clouds I see love shine. It keeps me warm as life grows colder.
In my life there's been heartache and pain. I was married to Linda McMahon. Can't stop now, I'm way turned on by daddy's little girl. I wanna know what love is. Watch out for my cats. I want you to show me. Suck on my lats. I wanna feel what love is. Can we please bring Roman Reigns into this three-way? I know you can show me. Oh, Aretha Franklin! The boyhood dream has come true for Shawn Michaels. Let's send it over to Barry Dudinsky in the aisle. Here comes Mantar, Hulk Hogan in the constellations with the Ultimate Warrior. Let's throw it over to Gene Okerlund.
It was weird and wrong.
Where is she?
Here, Justin. I got the polio cure. Go help your friend.
All right, come on, Steph. Let's go.
No, I'm staying here. I think I might have knocked my daddy up.
What? How does that work?
Well, he has a pussy on his chest.
And you? Do you have a penis in your pants?
I have everything in my pants.
Oof, hachi-machi. I guess that explains the stone hands.
The Nazis basically completed France's work. This would have been the cure for the Americans to give to FDR, but I guess it'd be better in Scott's hands. It's not like the U.S. is even in the war.
Well, now, Justin Rosero, you will join your friend Scott in the afterlife. It makes mad to have no one to exterminate, but it would be my pleasure to exterminate you. Say goodbye!
And just like that, the car burst through the door and crushed Vladimir Joseph Morse under its diseased tires.
D'Amato, you killed him! He was the only one keeping Hitler in check!
He was going to shoot you, you ungrateful fuck!
There they are, Adolf.
What the hell's your problem, Jesus?
You ruined my entire existence.
So you wanted the cure for polio? And what do you intend to give me in return? I do not need money nor jewels.
Do you want love?
Nein!
I could buy some of your art.
I hate art. You have 5 seconds before these calls the SS for you.
Let me check my DVDs. I can tell you how to win the war.
Go on.
Don't let the Japanese attack the Americans. Just destroy Japan. And that would be really great for our automotive industry.
You have proven yourself most useful. Go on, Yove.
You know, Hitler gets real bad rap, guys. I mean, without the Jews to kill, he's not really that bad of a guy.
He's conquering all of Europe.
Thanks, Adolf. Jesus, go fuck yourself, fucking asshole. Fuck face, eat my ass.
Oh, John, don't go.
I have to, Helen. I can't take more of that wrinkled snatch.
I'll never forget your cock, John.
God, let's go home.
Punch it, bitches. And AK-47 is my fucking address, huh? I'm not a star. Somebody lied. I got a chopper in the car. I got a chopper in the car.
I got a chopper in the car. Yeah. Our tale is of time travel and defrauding make-a-wish. And Rotella's dubious parentage, and Vince's little girl is quite the dish. She's more than just a princess who's been made by ICOPRO. There's something about Stephanie that they don't know. Stephanie. There's just something about Stephanie. Marvel's Ben Morse burned beyond recognition, and poor vagina dog Basil suffered long enough. Well, our friends may know all about the Rosemont Horizon, but they don't know a thing about father-daughter love. Our friends are all out adventuring and mucking with the past, but they've never been in love with Triple H, so our friends need not be asked. This crazy holiday special where Scott's faked polio, but there's something about Stephanie that they don't know. Stephanie. There's just something about Stephanie. Stephanie. There's just something about Stephanie. Merry Christmas, PTBN. Sub is a guy that thinks he's pushed in. He's also known as a jobber.
Jobber.
Always talking about wanting to win and just sits on his broke ass. So, no, I don't want your number, no. Yay. I don't want to give you mine, and no. Yay. I don't want to see you wrestle nowhere, no. Yay. I don't want to pay you a dime, and no. I don't want no sub. A sub is a guy that can't get no love from me. Hanging out on the catering side while I need to decide. He's trying to holler at me. No, I don't want no sub. Sub is a guy that can't get no love from me. Hanging out on the catering side while I need to decide. He's trying to holler at me. The sub is begging me. Off's kind of weak, but I know he cannot pop me. Because I want Kevin Nash, but that sub's looking like trash. He can't even beat Ron Bass. So, no, I don't want your number. No, I don't want to give you mine. And no, I don't want to see you wrestle nowhere. No, I don't want to pay you a dime. And no, I don't want no sub. Scott Casey is a guy that can't get no love from me. Hanging on the catering side while I need to decide. He's trying to holler at me. I don't want no sub. Brunzel is a guy that can't get no love from me. Hanging on the catering side while I need to decide. He's trying to holler at me. If you don't have long hair and you're balding, oh yes, son, I'm talking to you. If you think you can replace Tama, oh yes, son, I'm talking to you. If you're quite portly like fat ass brother Love, oh yes, Virgil. Talking to you. Want to get with me for fuck money? Oh, no. I don't want no. No. Subs. No.
Submarine.
Subs. What?
It's supposed to be talking about submarines.
No. I don't want no subs. What?
Submarines.
I don't know what you're talking about.
Hey, my son, Brett.
What?
Sub
is a guy that can't get no love. Sub from me. Hanging on the catering side while I need to decide. Trying to holler at me. I don't want no subs. A sub is a guy that can't get no love from me. Hanging on the catering side while I need to decide. Trying to holler at me. See, if you can't really expand my ratings, then that leaves you in the back with subs at catering. I don't want to see you blading. And if you're in the killer bees to lose bumping job from coast to overseas, so let me give you something to bitch about. And a date your mind with intentions to job you out. Can't forget the focus on the pay-per-view in front of me. Try to sell it on DVD and digital TV screen. Satisfy the universe with something spectacular while you go cry to Dave Meltzer. Then I get back at you, booking the card with precision. Junkyard Dog is what I envision. Can't beat talent acquisition from Bill Watts' Mid-South Expedition. Mr. Big Dick Vince, if you really want to know. Ask Jim Duggan, he'll just say, ho, not really. Jake Roberts leading the top team, stepping on your dreams. But you don't hear me, though. I don't want no sub. A sub is a guy that can't get no love from me. Hanging on the catering side while I need to decide. What? Shut the fuck up, Stu. I don't care what you're talking about. What do you mean? We're not talking about substitutions at the Survivor Series?
I was talking about submarines, the Nazi submarines.
Oh. Oh, yeah. All right. Hey, all right. Let me rewrite these lyrics then. So yeah, Hitler wanted submarines. He didn't want Royal Rumble substitutions?
In the submarines.
Oh. So he means like marine stuff then?
Yeah.
Like John Cena? That kind of marine?
Jim Knight had a job for me.
Oh, like who?
Jim Knight had his other...
Who?
He's really just fucking my shit up, you know? He's, his hair is in the sink, and he's banging my daughter, and it's just...
R.I.P. Left Eye! Chili, come to daddy!
Scott had murdered his way to the top, and by following that damn dog's nose, they stumbled upon the place where the last child receiving a wish was hiding.
All right, so WrestleMania 10 or 17?
Well, I mean, those Freak McMahon twins were magic together. But Bret and Owen D'Amato tearing it up at 10 can't be beat. Wait a minute. You sure we're in the right place, Basil?
I guarantee it. My nose is never wrong. Number one on the waiting list is behind that door, along with another smell, a hint of denim and leather, a touch of Latin, something familiar yet disappointing.
Come here, boy. It's almost time.
Time? What are you guys talking about? The hell was that?
but who to their wandering eyes should appear but good old Will from Texas with a gun and a sneer.
Hey, guys, what are you doing here?
Hey, what are we doing here? What the hell are you doing here? It's like the last place I'd see you at. You're kind of far away from Texas, dude.
Hey, man, I defrauded the Make-A-Wish Foundation to meet Triple H.
You did? Wait a minute, you were number one on the waiting list?
Yeah, man, I told him I had AIDS, and that, you know, if you give them AIDS, they push you right to the top of the list, you know, thinking you don't have long to live.
Wait a minute. AIDS? It's fucking genius, dude. I'm going to get polio. Dude, I should have got AIDS.
Well, anyways, man, that's what I got, what I came here for.
Wait, what was your wish? I mean, I wanted to meet Triple H, duh. I mean, you obviously knew that. So what? Wait a minute, what are you doing here?
Well, wait a minute, man. I wanted to meet him, too. That's why I blew his brains out.
So you wanted to meet... Hold on. I'm going to take a deep breath. And you're going to see that sentence again. You what?
No, see for yourself. Look.
Wait a minute. No! Shit! So close. It's so close! Son of a bitch! Fuck. God damn Texas. Fuck. Oh, fuck this. Ugh! Guess it's back to the Holy Order of Gables for me. Fuck!
Now, Basil, now!
Basil leapt like he'd never leapt before. He dug his teeth into Scott's testicles, ripping and gnawing like Virgil at a buffet.
Ah! Fuck! Ow! No! Jesus, Basil! Fuck!
Take that, Scott. Now you're sterile. I mean, not that you're going to have kids. I mean, not that you couldn't. I mean, it's perfectly fine. You're there a lot of older fathers. Anything's possible. But sterile. Like my empty soulless spirit. Brad and Chad are back again, baby. Back in business. The business of tearing up your balls. My master plan has come to fruition.
Your master plan?
I'm sorry, sir.
Benjamin! What the fuck's wrong with your face?
You left me by a lava pit to die.
Dude, you're... Ugh, you need a cane mask. Will, stop looking. You know what, Morsha, burned up freak? You may be able to take my dreams away from me, but there is no way your fucking crippled ass could stop me from stomping this fucking dog finally to death.
No, Scott, please. I was enchanted.
Fuck you!
Scott stomped and stomped until little Basil was no more.
You heartless prig. You're like Toshiaki Kawada on a bad night.
Yeah, heartless, yes. Bootless, never. Fucking stupid fucking dog!
Scott killed another dog. Yeah, because killing dogs is way worse than Cain and Killian Dane romancing the Empire. We could call it Cain and Dane, starring Kevin Kelly as Han Solo. A live Han Solo.
Big fucking deal. You killed two dogs? Pfft. Your life is over, Criscolo. Not like me, who runs the website for cross-gen comics. Fucking Sigil and Sojourn in the First. It's all one big universe, baby. I swear by the Great Stonehenge, you will rue the day you crossed.
But again, in the weakest of plot twists, the DeLorean burst in and crushed Ben Morse under its Deus Ex Machina tires.
Kuzumo Sespa in my DeLorean. War is over, I'm a piece of Mandalorian. The story is dumb, Star Wars historian Steven Debate.
Pull him over a few more times, will you?
Scott, we're back! We have the cure!
Back and forth, the car rolled over Morse's withered and broken corpse.
What the fuck are you doing here? Cure for what?
Your polio!
Oh, that! Oh, I don't have polio. Do I look like I have polio? I was faking to defraud a children's charity.
Are you fucking kidding me? You piece of shit, you selfish bastard! You have no idea what we've been through!
Billy Joel is dead, you selfish prick.
Who's Billy Joel?
I can't believe this. We traveled through time and space for you, and for what? All those burgers, all those fries, for what? Some bullshit lie?
What's this pile of blood and fur on the ground?
It's bad enough you defraud a charity, Scott! But you lied to me, you're PIC! You're a real son of a morse!
JR, please!
That's it, man! I'm out of here!
Justin opened the door to leave, but was stunned to hear a familiar voice over a loudspeaker.
Das is your 6 o'clock curfew. Everyone better be in the houses in the next 10 minutes or we will begin the executions.
What the fuck is going on out there?
Why, it's curfew.
Was that Hitler?
Yeah, I mean, he's been in power ever since they won the war.
Oh, God. How did they win? He didn't pop your pee. How did they win the war?
We never entered the war. No matter how much we provoked Hitler, he never attacked us. Eventually, he staged an invasion from Japan, which he obliterated.
Oh, well, that's nice. How's the auto industry doing?
Booming.
Great. Are you satisfied? Are you satisfied with this madness, you maniac? You know what I don't get? How did this dead piece of shit, asshole Ben Morse, know we were going back in time? Bradley, did you stooge on us?
Nope, I didn't even know, remember?
Well then, how did he fucking know, Brad? How could this day get any worse?
It was me, Justin. It was me all along.
Kevin Kelly, why?
4 years of plays. 4 years. I can't even look Jim Ross in the face anymore. This contract with Place to Be Nation has killed me. Have you ever had to explain to Jay Briscoe why you screamed, J. Arsenio D'Amato Driller? You think that guy has any patience? You all busted my balls for abandoning the Kevin Kelly show. So how's this for finishing strong? I finished so strong, I joined the Nazis, and now I rule the world with them. How does that feel, you pasty fuck?
I warned you guys. I warned you not to mess with me.
Jesus, just leave us alone.
Oh, you know this creep? He's been hanging out by the dock ripping feet off ducks for weeks.
You played with the fabric of the universe, and now you're going to pay the consequences. Hitler's still alive. No Billy Joel. Stephanie McMahon, a literal deity. You reap what you sow, gentlemen.
Can't you just do something to fix all this? You or your daddy?
I come not to save the world, but to judge it.
But...
do unto others as they have done unto you. You didn't listen, so now I don't. How does it feel, gents? To be damned.
All was lost, but suddenly a familiar voice boomed from afar.
Ho, 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 everyone!
Santa! Wait. Why is there a new Santa, D'Amato?
I didn't know that who had me kill her husband was Mrs. Claus. I should have figured it out, though, when her beard scratched my schmance.
Oh, it wouldn't be Christmas play without good old St. Nick.
You know, what's really hilarious about this whole thing? This is truly the first time this has anything to do with Christmas.
Well, I couldn't let a year go by without visiting my old pal Jesus. I still remember what you did to me all those years ago. Murdered me in cold blood.
Got that right. And you're looking to get your ass kicked again.
Oh, not this time, Brother Jesus. This time, I brought me some friends.
No friends you have can harm me.
Oh, but I think they can. My friends are three iron nails.
Well, hold on a minute, Santa.
What do you say, guys? The world may be shitty as fuck, but at least we can take out some of our hate on this pretentious asshole.
Yeah! Woo!
Yeah. Oh, my God!
I wish I could tell you that Jesus came out on top that day, but on this afternoon, Santa had the last laugh. The reindeer helped Santa raise the cross from the ground, while Mrs. Claus handed out cookies underneath the banners of the Fourth Reich. Let's give thanks to the Lord above, Santa.
Have a holly jolly Christmas, it's the best time of the year.
I don't know if there'll be snow, but have a cup of cheer.
Have a holly jolly Christmas, and when you walk down the street,
say hello to friends you know and everyone you meet.
Oh, oh, a mistletoe hung off my balls where you can see.
Somebody waits for your kisser, what's for me?
Every year you kisses, and you feel the red, red, red.
Oh, my golly, have a holly jolly Christmas.
Christmas.
This year.
My son died in an accident.
Fools, this is where I'd wrap everything up with where everyone is. But you know what? They're all slaves of the Germans. Yes, Kevin Kelly and Air Fuhrer are now like the Blood Brothers. All I wanted to do was a simple story about a sexy pilot and Kane romancing the galaxy. Is that so bad? Is that so out there? But you guys couldn't even give it to me. From here on out, I want all of you to refer to me as Air Kelly. I will make the streets run red with the blood of the nation. The entire Place to Be Nation, Greg Phillips, Tim Capel, Nick Duke, and Todd Weber, executed. Jason Greenhouse, ripped apart by wolves. Chad Campbell, Jordan Duncan, and Steve Willey, they're all making love to Kane tonight. Jennifer and Miranda, beaten to death with a sack of 21 turtles. Wham! Bam! Turtles to the head! That pig D'Amato, I'll banish him to a life of loneliness on Stud Island. Andy, Reish, Machado, Richer, Kelly, Claire, Cowboy Pete, and Will from Texas, I will tear you all asunder with my collection of Bastion Booger showers. Yeah, I have them all. Glenn Butler, we're cool. Matt Rotella, you have suffered more abuse from these guys than anyone, so bring your robot hairy ass over to the Nazi side of things. Nate, you do a fine Virgil impression, so you are welcome in Kelly Manor as the court jester. Aaron George, you son of a bitch, you are, as Jim Ross would say, a Jezebel Kang. So Brad, help me resurrect Ben Morse's broken body so we can finish strong all over Scott and Justin. Merry Christmas to all, and all seek Kevin Kelly. Ha 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 ha! I don't understand the context of this. While D'Amato went to town on a... Why am I gay for Roman Reigns? This one's going to be hard. Okay. Yo, I'll tell you what I want, what I really, really want. You'd think there would be many guns, but you'd be wrong. Instead of main... We live in a weird time. While Justin and company were blaspheming away through time... One more time.
Yeah, blaspheming.
You're blaspheming. Mm. Everyone's lost their sense of humor.
Well, you know all the other stuff you've done is on record and public, right?
Well, that's old. Okay. I can't do anything about that. Okay. I was young and dumb.
I guess that should be licked himself, right?
Oh, yeah. And Basil. Is it Basil?
It's Basil, but I like that you always call him Basil, so go for it. Whatever feels right.
All right, here we go. 15 again. Going to Russia time, right? Is that it?
Whoa, going to Russia time. Yeah, for 10-4. The longest time.
So you want to get big and you want to get slick, then you down that ICOPRO way click. Quick. Here we go. I don't know the anthem. You'll just play an anthem now.
No, you got to sing it.
I don't know it.
You know, Nikolai Volkov, the one you always sing. Oh,
I don't know the words.
You don't need to know the words. You know, it's a fucking Russian national anthem. Fuck them. Just all right. Mumble some shit in Nikolai Volkov's voice. That's all he does.
All right. 9 months later, Robot Rotella and
Martha Schmuck.
Okay. So how's this for far-fetched? Jason Rosero... Jesus, I can't even read your name.
Come on.
Sorry.
In the continental United... Sorry, we gotta take this
again. That's all right. You wanna start again?
Am I reading this like a German, or am I reading
No, I think
like
this is
me?
You, like, angry, like you've snapped.
because I'm doing like a fucking Phineas and Ferb Doofenshmirtz impression.
You're gonna say Phineas and Henry Godwin.
Ooh, that would be even better. All right,
as long as you wear those overalls.
Andy, Richie, Machado.
It's Reesh.
Andy, Reesh, Machado.
Richer. What's
Richer? Andy, Reach. Like Reach?
Reesh.
Or Reesh? Reesh?
Yeah, Reesh.
He's got a stupid name. Yeah. What's his fucking cat's name? Richer?
Richer.
Glenn Butler? We're cool.
It's Butler. Glenn Butler.
He then made his way to Jay Hinchy's house.
Jay Hinchy.
Hinchy?
Hinchy. Oh my. Like Grinchy.
Gotcha. Hold on, my dog is making noise over there.
I'm not giving any outtakes. You're killing all this.
Stan Lee then...